The listeners.
By Walter de la Mare.
Is there anybody there? Said the traveller, knocking on the moonlit door, and his horse in the silence champed the grass of the forest's ferny floor.
And a bird flew up of the turret above the traveller's head, and he smote upon the door again the second time. Is there anybody there? He said.
But no one descended to the traveller, not a head from the leaf-fringed sill. Leaning over and looked into his grey eyes, where he stood perplexed and still, but only a host of phantom listeners that dwelt in the lone house then stood listening in the quiet of the moonlight to that voice from the world of men.
Stood thronging the faint moonbeams and the dark stair that goes down to the empty hall, hearkening in an air stirred and shaken by the lonely traveller's call.
And he felt his heart, their strangeness, their stillness answering his cry, while his horse moved, cropping the dark turf, neath the starred and leafy sky.
He suddenly smote on the door, even louder, and lifted his head. Tell them I came, and no one answered, but I kept my word, he said.
Nevertheless, sir, made the listeners, by every word he spake, fell echoing through the shadowness of the still house from the man, the one man left awake.
Aye, they heard his foot on the stirrup, and the sound of iron and stone, and how the silence surged softly backwards when the plunging hoofs were gone.